Students, in the last class we have seen what is meant by controllability, what is meant by observability, and how to identify whether the system is completely controllable by means of Kalman's test of controllability and Gilbert's test of controllability. Now in this class we are going to see about the observability. So the observability is nothing but the problem related in determining the system state by measuring the output for the finite length of the time. Hence, observability is defined as a system is said to be completely observable if every state x of t can be completely identified by measurement of the output over a finite time interval. Controllable means you will have a control towards your system state variables. Observability means you will be measuring the output for a finite amount of time. So, for whether you are you could able to observe the measured value within that stipulated amount of time. So if your system is not completely observable, means then few of the system variables or the state variables could not be measured. That is the thing. Now we'll solve one problem. Here also you have Kalman's test for observability and Gilbert's test for observability. In Kalman's test, you have to identify your observable matrix. Observability matrix, that is QO. It is C transpose, A transpose, C transpose, and it goes on till A transpose to the power of n minus 1 into C transpose. In case of Kalman's test for controllability, the formula is you need to identify the composite matrix. Formula is B, AB, A square B, and it goes on. Okay. Kalman's test of observability means C transpose. So from this only you can, it is very clear that with the application of some input, if you could able to measure your output within a finite amount of time, then you can say the system is observable. If you were not able to identify the system variable that is at its output within that measurement of time, some of the variable is going to get it miss. So we can say the system is not completely observable. Here also we are using Kalman's test for observability, and the formula to identify your Kalman's test for observability is QO is equal to C transpose, A transpose, C transpose. I'll write it very clearly. The formula to identify your observability matrix is QO. Formula is C transpose, A transpose, C transpose, A transpose square into C transpose. Like that it goes on till the number of state variables. You all know what is meant by transpose. For example, in a problem, if your C matrix is given like this, 1, 0, 1. Okay. If you want to identify your C transpose, then it will be written as 1, 0, 1. That is, whatever it is written in column wise, it will be written as a row wise. Now, x of t is equal to, I'll show along with one problem. Take down this problem. Evaluate the observability of the system as shown for this state equation and output equation. What is your state equation? X dot of t is equal to Ax of t plus Bu of t. Y of t is equal to Cx of t plus Du of t. So you know A matrix is 1, 1, minus 2, minus 1. What is the B matrix given? B matrix given in the problem is 0, 1. What is the C matrix given? It is 1, 0. What is the formula to obtain? It is your Kalman's test for controllability. Under Kalman's test for control observability, the formula is you need to identify your observability matrix QO. Formula is C transpose, A transpose, C transpose. Why I have stopped with two terms means it is your first term and it is going to be your second term. Why I stopped with two terms means here the order of your state variable, the number of state variable in one problem is 2. So only 2 it is referred. Okay. Now I want to identify C transpose. C transpose, C matrix is this one. C transpose, if you identify, you will get 1, 0. Next one, if I want to identify A transpose, whatever you have it in the row, that you need to write it in the column wise. So I will be getting 1, 1, minus 2, minus 1. So it is your A transpose matrix and it is your C transpose matrix. When you do so, so in C transpose matrix, you have to write it as 1, 0. In A transpose, you need to multiply A with C. Okay, when you multiply A with C, you will get 1, 1. So it is your observability matrix that you have observed. So when you identify the determinant value for this observability matrix, if you find the determinant value, it is equal to 1. So where your observability matrix is not equated to 0, it is not equal to 0. When the determinant value of QO is non-zero, then the rank of the matrix is going to be the number of state variable, and we can say the system is completely observable. Clear? One more problem we'll solve. Evaluate the observability of the system. A matrix given, C matrix, B matrix. Now for this A transpose is equal to 0, 1, 0. So whatever you have written in row, that will be written in the column wise. 0, 0, 1, 0, minus 2, minus 3. It is your A transpose. C transpose means it will be 3, 4, 1. Okay. Now using Kalman's test, if you want to identify your observability, you have to write the formula observability matrix. C transpose, A transpose, C transpose, A transpose square, C transpose. Here I have used only three terms. Why? Because the order of your state variable is going to be, the number of state variable defined in the problem is 3. So just substitute the value of C transpose here, multiply A transpose, C transpose here, and find out the square for A transpose and multiply with C transpose and put it in this column. Once you have done with, you are getting a observability matrix as such. After this, you need to identify what is the determinant value for this. So when you identify the determinant value, you are getting 0. So when you get 0 for after identifying the determinant matrix, then the rank of the matrix is not equal to the number of state variable, and you can say the system is not completely observable. So whatever problem now we have solved is to identify the system observability by means of Kalman's test. And we have another test, Gilbert's test of controllability. So to test your controllability and observability, you have two tests. One is your Kalman's test, another one is your Gilbert's test. So to check your controllability, you have to identify composite matrix. To check your observability, you need to identify your observability matrix. In both the thing, the formula to identify your controllability matrix is B, A, B, and it goes on. The formula to identify your observability matrix is C transpose, A transpose, C transpose, and it goes on. Okay, this is how you need to identify your controllability matrix and observability matrix. Now we need to go for another test, that is Gilbert's test. So under Gilbert's test, we have solved some problems to identify the controllability. Now we will be solving one more problem to identify your observability. Consider this particular problem. Evaluate the observability of the system by using Gilbert's test. A matrix given, B matrix given, C matrix given. The formula to identify the controllability under Gilbert's test. So in Gilbert's test, if I wanted to test my system controllability, the formula to be used is C. The formula to be used is, it is M inverse B. None of the element in M inverse B should be 0. Likewise, to test the Gilbert's test of observability, you need to find out CM. So you have to identify the new term called C. After identifying this, none of the element in the matrix is 0. For example, when you observe for this particular problem, this is the problem. So A matrix, B matrix, C matrix is given. You have to identify what is the new value of C. The new value of C is nothing but your diagonalizing, where it is M into C. M is nothing but your model matrix. As the order of your, it should be same as that of your order of the matrix N cross N. So here it will be 3 cross 3. Therefore, you will get 3 eigenvalues, that is lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3. First, you have to identify your characteristics equation lambda I minus A. From this, you need to identify what is your eigenvalue. By keeping this eigenvalue, you frame your model matrix. Either like this also you can frame the model matrix. Otherwise, you can, it is the fastest way of framing your model matrix. That is, first row will be 1, 1, 1. Second row will be lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3. Third row will be lambda 1 square, lambda 2 square, lambda 3 square, like this. It goes on. Okay. Once you have identified the model matrix, then multiply it with the C matrix and check whether any of the element in the identified CM matrix is 0. So if any one of the element in the C matrix is 0, then we can say the system is not completely observable. This is how you need to identify your system controllability and observability. And with this, your module 2 is over. And for further doubt clarification, you people can ask me the doubts through Google Classroom. Try to solve some more problems and make clear with practice. Thank you, students.